the Western scholars and Orientalists and great Western historians. I'm finishing on their comments. They appreciated the personality of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a very good way. John Bronowski, he writes in his book The Ascent of Man. It was printed in London in 1973, the edition which I am quoting from, which I have, page 165-166. He writes, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had been firm that Islam was not to be a religion of miracles only. It became an intellectual content, a pattern of contemplation, research, and analysis. Then Robert Briefold, another Western famous historian, in his famous book, The Making of Humanity, he writes in page 190-191, a well-deputed Western scholar, he said, for although there is not a single aspect of European growth in which the decisive influence of Islamic culture is not traceable. Further, the same author, Robert Briefold, in The Making of Humanity, same page, he writes, what we call science arose in Europe as a result of a new spirit of inquiry, of new methods of investigation, experiment, observation, measurement and development, unknown to the Greeks. That spirit and those methods were introduced into the European world by the Arabs. This has been appreciated by Robert Briefold, famous book on the making of humanity. Then Joseph Schacht and C.E. Bosworth, their article, joint article in the book The Legacy of Islam, page 427, 426 and 427. These both famous religious and historical scholars and juristic scholars, Western thinkers, they say there is no doubt that the Islamic sciences exerted a great influence on the rise of European science. And in this renaissance of knowledge in the West, there was no single influence, but diverse ones. The main influence was, of course, from Spain, then from Italy and Palestine, through the Crusaders who had mixed with Muslims and seen the effect of sciences in Muslim culture. So they brought this influence to European history. Then Reverend George Bush, he writes in his book, The Life of Muhammad, he says, no revolution in history effected by the religion has introduced greater changes into the state of the civilized world than that which was grown out of the rise, progress, and permanence of Muhammadanism. And the last reference which I will to close my speech is by the professor, famous author and historian of the West, Professor Hitti. He writes in his famous book, History of the Arabs, page 383 and 387. He says, the bulk of this scientific material, whether astronomical, astrological or geographical, penetrated the West through Spanish and Sicilian Islamic channels. And then the same Professor Hitti writes on page 568 to 573, he says, not only are most of the star names in European language of Arabic origin, but a number of technical terms are also likewise of Arabic etymology, and testify to the rich legacy of Islam to Western Europe. This was the legacy given by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, legacy of knowledge, legacy of wisdom, legacy of research, legacy of sciences.